I am almost fully convinced at this point that Call of Duty is treating this year as a big experiment, a big social experiment, to see exactly what they can do and what they can get away with when it comes to the Call of Duty franchise, and more importantly with Modern Warfare 2. It's pretty clear that they don't care about what's going on with the current community. Instead, they're actually focusing on gaining a brand new community. They're focusing on getting a new community of players that have never experienced the previous Call of Duty games, at least in the past 3 years. That way they can monetize them to the fullest extent, sell them things that have already been purchased while completely disregarding the community that's stuck by for years and years and years and years. And look no further than what we ended up getting today. The Tracer Pack Butch Operator Bundle. It's another operator pack that I'm not going to buy, and I'm sure that there's going to be hundreds of thousands of people that end up buying it. And the sad thing is, the blueprints that are in this are the same blueprints that many of us purchased back in Modern Warfare 2019, when bundles first became relevant. Back during Season 4, there was a Freedom Bundle, which included an M4A1 called the 1776. And this is what it looks like. I have it right now in my Modern Warfare game. Now, mind you, this released during Season 4 of Modern Warfare 2019 for 1,600 COD points, and it included a total of 4 weapon blueprints. That includes the 1776 M4A1. We have the handgun, the shield, and a combat knife blueprint, with a calling card and a vehicle horn, which doesn't exist in Modern Warfare 2, nor does it exist in Warzone 2.0. And you know what else doesn't exist? This particular blueprint doesn't exist in that game, so they took it upon themselves to re-add it. Albeit a little bit different, but pretty much the same exact thing. I think the death effects are a little different, the tracers look a little upgraded, but the point still stands. And I've already seen a bunch of people saying this on Twitter to the Charlie Intel post: if you don't like it, don't buy it. That just does not apply here. I'm sorry. It just doesn't. If you don't like it, don't buy it. That's something that I would have even said back in Modern Warfare 2019, 2020, when the bundles first came out. When the things are unique and brand new and you've never seen them before and they're flashy and unique. Yeah, I get it. If you don't like it, don't buy it. But if we're talking about something that we bought in 2020, we were able to utilize all the way up until just last year, and now it's been taken away from us for the 2.0 era, you're completely missing the mark if you say, if you don't like it, don't buy it. That's not the point. The point is they're taking stuff that we already bought and they're giving it back to us again in a bundle because of the arbitrary 2.0 era. That is the problem. That is the problem that I'm focusing on. That's what I've always focused on, and that's been the problem throughout this entire year. So the fact that there are people out there that still just cannot grasp that concept of repurchasing things you've already purchased, it's just sad to me. It's sad because it shows me that Call of Duty is doing exactly what it needs to do in order to capture a community that just does not care. That just doesn't care. They don't care as much as Call of Duty doesn't care. As long as they can jump into their war zone and play their shipment 24/7, all things are good in the world. It's only going to get worse. The microtransactions are only going to get worse. The pay-to-win stuff is only going to get worse. They have taken their inch, and now they're going to take a mile when it comes to the next few games. They've already shown that people are willing to buy the DMZ benefits. They've already shown that people are willing to rebuy the things that they've already bought before. Call of Duty is seriously, at least for me and in my opinion, they're going to have to impress me, because the only thing that Modern Warfare 2 has done this year is push me away from a franchise that I have deeply, deeply loved over the past decade of my life. They've taken it and they've crunched it up into a ball and they've thrown it in the trash. The soul that used to be there's gone. The passion behind the developers completely vaporized, just gone, eviscerated. It's not there. It's just not there. And that to me is the most heart-wrenching thing, because I've been able to meet these devs. I've had a chance to speak with them face to face and know exactly how passionate they are about the game that they were creating. And now it's like they're just locked up in a box and they can't say anything. They're not allowed to talk about anything at all except for bundles. They can only say how happy they are about the bundles coming out. And trust me, I follow plenty of devs, and there's plenty of them that only talk about bundles on their social media. It's really sad. It's actually so sad. Anyway, that is it. Obviously, I can't control what you spend your money on. I don't care if you spend it on hookers and blow. But all I can do is suggest that you maybe don't spend it on $20 bundles that feature things that we've already bought in the past. Maybe you didn't buy them in the past. It's still not worth buying it. Just isn't, man. 4th of July. If this was in a previous game, we would have gotten these blueprints for free. We would have had some in-game challenges to give us these blueprints for free, maybe even earn that operator for free, but not anymore. We don't have events like that anymore. We don't get things like that. So anyway, that's it. Thank you for watching. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.